Welcome back to the Morning Show here on Arise News. Joining us now to review some of the headlines of today's newspapers from around the world is Arise News analyst Emmanuel Efeni. Good morning, Emmanuel.
Good morning, Ruben.
Good morning, Leila.
Good morning, Tundu. Let's start with this day newspapers. The lead story, military police absent as Southwest governors launch Operation Amotekun. Outfit not tantamount to state police, says Fayemi. Southwest experiments with regional cooperation. Of course, most of Nigerian newspapers have this story as their lead. Vanguard newspaper, Amotekun, not agenda to divide Nigeria, says Southwest governors. Say it's not regional police, but community policing. People want to sabotage our efforts. Fayemi, why we launch Amotekun Akeredolu, while the Guardian looks at it from a different perspective, fresh calls for restructuring as Southwest Security Body takes off. Yes, at last, the Amotekun security arrangement by the Southwest governors has been launched in Ibadan yesterday. Because the police, the army, had no representation there. And many have been wondering why they were not there. But I did not expect that they will be there.
Why didn't you expect that?
Yeah, because from the way they've been talking before this statement, before this launch, they don't see themselves as perhaps co-equals.
I think it's ridiculous. They should have been there.
No, it's then, not of course, it's not about equality. Of course, three governors did not also attend the launch.
That has been explained.
Explained as a bad weather, preventing some governors from attending.
No, the governor of Osun State was not there, but he was represented by his deputy governor. The governor of Ogun State was not there, because it clashed with another event, the inauguration of an elders elders council, and he had to attend that. He sent his deputy governor to represent him. It's only the governor of Lagos that gave the excuse of poor weather. But there is no indication that the Lagos state government is not part of the initiative. As for the absence of the military and the police, well, that would seem to have contradicted what we were told originally. What the governor of Ekiti State announced was that, you know, the police, the other security agencies will be involved. Considering the meetings that have been held with the president, the national security advisor, and even with the inspector general of police. But the various security units on the ground said that they didn't get any directive from their bosses. And you know how the military operates. I mean, they don't take instructions from those state governors. They will only take instructions from their bosses. And we expect that, you know, in being able to put this in place, that there will be coordination, there will be collaboration between the Operation Amotekun and the relevant security agencies, particularly the police and the civil defense, so that there can be synergy, you know, in terms of efficiency. However, certain things came out of the launch yesterday. One is the position of the governors that this is not an attempt to create state police, that is simply to address the challenges of banditry, insecurity, kidnapping, and there would seem to be a strong justification for that. And to the extent that they have the concurrence of the president and the Office of the National Security Advisor, that would seem to be in order. And then secondly, they also made it clear that Amotekun, Operation Amotekun, would not be involved in political activities. And I think that that clarification is also important, and they should abide by their own declaration.
Absolutely.
Because the fear about state police, regional police, or community policing, as you may have called it, as you may call it, is that, you know, they could end up like the Native Authority Police of the First Republic, whereby, you know, these policemen were hijacked, these security units were hijacked and were being used for political purposes. We will not expect the politicization of Operation Amotekun, whatever value it brings to the table. The third clarification that we can hold on to now is that the headquarters will be in Ibadan. But we also like to know, how would the operational command function? Yeah. You know, is it, does it mean that the governor for your state will be the chief commander, or, you know, there will be some kind of structure that will be worked out from one state
that
to the other?
That technology may cause, when you talk of chief commander, being a governor, being chief commander.
Just by way of fair.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, the bottom line is that people are not safe in their beds. And it's sort of positive that governors are actually making an attempt to do something rather than twiddle their thumbs. Mm-hmm. So I do think that people should give it a chance, you know. And I don't really appreciate the boycott by the police.
No, well, the absence, I don't want to call it boycott, absence of the police and the army does not mean that they will not cooperate. You see, the well-trained army, well-trained police coming to rub shoulders with
Amoteku
put together. They don't see themselves as being in the same class.
But in
terms of cooperation, they will come. I want
hope
to believe
so,
they will
because for me, the optics are important to because, show that everybody from every sector.
If the police get intelligence report about criminals and criminality from Amoteku, they will utilize it.
I hope so.
If the army needs to go into an area to smoke out some criminals, bandits, and the Amoteku had already located where these bandits are, they will utilize that information. So I want to believe that they will cooperate.
Let us then assume then, going by a Finnish logic, that the absence of the police and the other security agencies was tactical. Because for the police, it will be an open admission of their own ineffectiveness, of their own failure, as it were. But definitely for Operation Amoteku hunters and patrolmen and guards to be able to achieve results, they will need to coordinate with the police. They may not have the kind of capacity that the military can deploy in certain situations, or that the civil defense can deploy, or that the police can deploy, considering the fact that this will be majorly a collection of hunters and OPC, who may not have the requisite training that soldiers and policemen can bring to the table, no matter what we say about them.
I hope the police will still get the support they used to receive from state governors. Vehicles and other logistics.
No, each of these states have what you call a state security trust fund. And the understanding is that, you know, the state security trust fund will do a lot more for these operational Amoteku units.
Not at the expense of what they've been doing for the police?
Not necessarily.
Okay.
Not necessarily.
Let's move on. The Daily Independent, a different dimension. Northern youths oppose Southwest governor's launch of Amoteku. Says it's a threat to peace, national unity. Compare it to Boko Haram, IPOB. It's not regional police, fire me. A response to federal government's failure, Mogalu. Babatope says, scheme highly commendable. Those youths must be mischievous.
I don't even think they should be given the time of day.
They must be mischievous to say that because we have Hizba. Have they divided the country? No. We had vigilante groups, Bakasi boys at one time. Did they divide the country?
The Ikpesu boys.
They only helped in securing the environment, as it were. So this is just some mischief from a group of youths. Now, but above the masthead of the Daily Independent is a story that should worry Nigerians once more. South Africans give Nigerians ultimatum to leave their communities. And when I read that story, some indigenous of Kemos and Upington areas of Northern Cape Province in South Africa Thursday morning gave Nigerians and other foreign nationals a 12-hour ultimatum to vacate their communities. And this, according to Adetola Olubanjo, president of Nigerian Union in South Africa. Recall that in the wake of that xenophobic attack after the visit of President Buhari to South Africa, they talked about these early warning signals which both countries should act on. So I hope we'll not hear that Nigerians have been killed after this ultimatum. The South African government will live up to its expectations.
Well, I'm sure that the relevant authorities at the Federal Ministry of Foreign Affairs and at the Diaspora Commission will also, you know, have read this story. The thing to do is to collaborate with the president of Nigerian Union in South Africa and to engage the South Africans. In other words, you know, at the Nigerian end, we must be proactive. We must draw the attention of the South African authorities to this to prevent the kind of crisis that we had previously. And we know, you know, how that affected the relationship both at government level and at people level.
Yes. The morning after the release from Harry and Meghan, the Times of UK, Charles threatens to halt Harry and Meghan's cash. No blank check if they step away. Crisis talks with Queen, couple ignored its overstatement. And of course, the Daily Telegraph, the Queen calls family crisis. And writing in the front page of the Daily Telegraph, Alison Pearson, the columnist, stated that royalty is like being a virgin. You can't be a bit royal. That's
I like that.
It's literally what Harry and Meghan, the Duke and the Duchess of Sussex, what they're trying to do is to live their lives on their own terms.
Oh, please.
They still want to be part of royalty. What they're actually giving up financially is just about 5% of their financial entitlement.
Exactly.
And that's one concern, one major concern, because they draw their resources. One, that's Prince Harry, from inheritance. He has substantial inheritance from what they call a bona vacantia, which is you know, something that the royalty enjoys as privilege. When a commoner dies intestate and he has resources, it reverts to the sovereign. Then there is a sovereign grant,
yes,
you know, under which they draw money. And then from Prince Charles, they take money from Prince Charles, from the Duchy of Cornwall.
95% of his money comes from
so
there.
So if Prince Charles says they will not get that money, then there may be an issue. And then people have raised questions about financial independence. How? If you still draw these resources and you still hold on to Frogmore Cottage. So these are the issues.
And the taxpayers still going to fund their security.
Yes. But if you listen to the British media and the American media, you see different flavor of these. In the American media, there seem to be a lot of support for...
Not to me, they should just walk out.
But they don't understand
it. I think they should just walk out.
It's not really the Americans that count.
And the Daily Independent simply says, Meghan flees to Canada.
Yes, so we hear.
After 6 weeks holiday. Meghan can't stand the heat, frankly.
Well,
anyway, thank you very much, Emmanuel Efeni.
Thank you.
We'll see you on Monday, right?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.